In this video, we're going to learn to use the array fill. And to begin, I'm just going to select a new empty workspace. And I'll choose my shape tool and draw some kind of a big shape that we can fill in with a special type of fill called the array fill. So I'll go ahead and select my shape. Of course, it begins as a step fill, but I could choose array fill. Now, an array fill can be made from an embroidery shape or an embroidery design. It could be more than one piece that you create or from your clip art library. And so if I choose array from the fill tab, it's going to choose from my clip art library. So it brings open the window to select from the clip art library where you can scroll through the clip art, obviously, that you know about. And if you watch my video about the clip art library, we'll talk more about it there, but I'll just look for a flower that we could place in the background of this design. And so once I select a little flower and say insert, as always, when I work with a clip art, I need to click and drag to set, first of all, the size of that flower. What size will it be in the array that it's going to create? And at what orientation do I want it? So basically something like that. And so you can see what happens. It's placed our flower over and over to fill up the background of our design. And this design, this embroidery object, is based as a dark blue outline, and it has two colors of fill, both red and purple. And the software is able to separate the red and the purple. So if I was to click right now, slow redraw, it would show us the way that this design is going to stitch out. And so it just takes a moment to calculate, I guess, all of the different paths of this array, so it's just slightly, perhaps slower than normal for coming up with the results. But now that it's done that, we can easily click on our tool to see the way that the stitches. And so see how it's able to do all of the red and then come back and add on all of the blue. And that is, so an array can be created from a single embroidery object or a multiple pieces of objects such as this flower. So let's go ahead and select this again and look at the fill properties. You see, like any shape, once you've selected the type, we have choices. And in this case, the first choice is the way that it fills in the shape, the style. And it set its shape fit, but there's rectangle fit, circular, contour, line, single line, shape fit, and line fit. And if I change it to rectangle, you'll see a slight difference. And again, if I go with circular and contour, and these will change, if I change the parameters, we'll see, we can enhance them, you know, to be just the perfect fit. That's the single line. This is called shape fit. And finally, line fit. And there are different times, depending on the shape that you're filling and the array that you're making, what object the array is, that these may look better, you know, than others. Let's go back to rectangle. So first of all, you can control an offset. That means if this is the outline, do we want to push the shapes outside of it or push them inside of it? That would be called the offset. And if I put a 2 millimeter offset, you can see how it pushes those stitches just a little bit outside of our shape, presumably 2 millimeters outside of the shape. And if I select it and change that offset to be a -2, then it will bring them inside of the shape. Let's move this over a little bit. Also notice, so I'm going to turn that offset off now, back to 0. And notice how the flowers are trimmed. So you can control, if you don't want any trimmed shapes like this, you can turn that off and it will only include elements that can be kind of fully stitched. It won't cut them like that. So that's an option, trim. Now, we have the ability to control the item rotation, so the rotation of the flower, horizontal spacing, vertical spacing, so the spacing between the rows of the flowers, and then a start angle and a slant angle. So that will can control kind of the direction that these flowers flow across the shape. And all of these settings that we can control mathematically can also be controlled using the Edit Nodes tool. So if I go ahead and turn on Edit Nodes, notice how it gives me a little angle with green nodes on it, and I can click those green nodes. If I click the lower right one, I can control, first of all, the horizontal spacing. And I can also control the start angle. So the angle with which, along which the rows go. If I grab the top handle, I can control the vertical spacing. I can also control the slant or the offset of the rows. And so this gives you a much more visual way of making adjustments to the patterns until you get just the look you're looking for. And as I change from rectangle fill to, let's say, circular fill, then also the changes happen to the available parameters. So with a circular fill, we're allowed horizontal spacing, not vertical spacing. But we now have the option to add in number of steps. And it's set right now at 6 steps. Let's turn it up to 8 so you can see how it adds. So it's the number of times that the flower is repeated around our circle. And with the Edit Nodes tool turned on, I can use the handles again to move the location of this arrangement. And this will allow me to control that horizontal spacing as well as the starting angle. And then this would enable me to control the number of steps. So how many circles go, how many flowers go in each circle is controlled with that tool there. So you can really control everything with the Edit Nodes tool. Or if you have specific numbers, you can come in and control them mathematically. And in each case, you will get very different results. So now that we choose contour, then probably the biggest change is going to be the distance between the rows and the distance between the flowers. And then it contours around our shape. So vertical, horizontal spacing, height and rotation, and then follow angle is on or off. So it's a very visual approach based on, like I said, the shape of the object and the shape of the actual array that we're filling it with. Single line will fill your shape across a single line. Shape fit will try and contour to the actual shape. Line fit goes around the line. So let's try it again. And this time, let's see here. I'll zoom out. I'm going to select our shape, and I can just move it off to the side. Or let's just remove it. Let's create a new shape. Let's create a star shape. And let's take this star and give it no fill and only make it a run stitch outline. Okay, so that's going to be the shape that we'll use to create our array. And then now let's just create a big shape that we can. So want to do this, I need to select both shapes. And now on the Fill tab, I choose Array. And see how it takes my star and fills it as an array inside of the other shape. And now we can select that shape and choose the different styles. So rectangle fill, contour, single line, shape fit, line fit, and circular fill. Yeah, and then you can control, obviously, the same concept. Choose Edit Nodes to control the number of steps, maybe the horizontal spacing, to get just the right array that makes you happy. So I hope you enjoyed this video on how to use the array fill.